The author of the video, KIKE CALVO, is an experienced National Geographic photography expert. The explanation of technical jargon is based on his own experience and interviews with his colleagues. Some of the questions and answers are included in the book. These are questions you probably would have, and CALVO has already got expert answers for you. I find this style of writing quite effective, injecting liveness into what otherwise could be dry reading. UAV photogrammetry is not just about obtaining pretty pictures. To realize its potential, you must georeference the pictures, produce an orthomosaic, and make 3D point clouds. Watch this video to find out what all these mean, and much more. Xu Wei Li, Sarah Schallenberger Brown Professor, Yale University, Editor-in-Chief, Agricultural and Forest Meteorology. What is photogrammetry? The combination of light, photo, drawings, gram, and measurements, metry, are known as photogrammetry. Until recently, photogrammetry was a very specific niche within the geospatial industry, a rather complex subject, accessible only to specialized professionals. However, this field is becoming more and more broadly accessible. Photogrammetry has become a field in which, despite the need for some initial training and effort to understand the basics, there are many useful applications, such as creating 3D maps using aerial images. To put it simply, aerial photogrammetry is the act of mounting a camera on an aerial vehicle and taking multiple photos of the ground as it flies. The resulting visuals are then processed in a powerful computer using specialized software that creates a survey grade output that is georeferenced and scaled. This allows us to make measurements from photographs, giving photographers the chance to pinpoint exact positions of surface points. With the advent and continuous evolution of computer imaging, the process of photogrammetry is becoming easier and easier. New generation software has contributed substantially to this concept of simply mounting a camera on an aerial vehicle and taking multiple photos of the ground as it flies. The camera is commonly airborne with its axis vertical, but oblique and horizontal, ground-based, photographs are also possible. Data reduction. Converting data into a more usable dataset is accomplished by stereoscopic line-of-sight geometry using both analytical and analog methods. In vertical aerial surveys, adjacent photos are overlapped. The two images of the same terrain are then superimposed for three-dimensional viewing by human operators or automated sensors. Did you know? Disadvantages of low oblique aerial photograph. With high oblique photographs, you cannot see what is known as dead ground. Parts of the area that are behind things like buildings and hills. And with low oblique photographs, you cannot see the horizon properly. There is also something called close-range photogrammetry, CRP. We will not dedicate time to this, but in essence, it consists of positioning everyday cameras closer to a subject to measure buildings, recreate forensic scenes, or model archaeological objects. It is also referred to as image-based modeling. There used to be real differences that justified the different naming between SPI and aerial photogrammetry, but nowadays, both techniques are 99% the same. With UAVs, everyday cameras, and new software available, the analog, line-of-sight, geometry is now obsolete. By analyzing almost every pixel in the images, and comparing highly overlapping sets of images, software packages are able to compute back to the third dimension, in the same way the human brain gets a sense of depth from the two eyes. Applications of photogrammetry. With these images, scientists, or even you, if you learn how to do it, can create numeric models of natural systems. This creates the possibility of developing predictions and controlling the effects of natural disasters. From earthquakes to tsunamis, to the flow of rivers descending from a mountain, the forces of nature can be more easily measured. Drones are a data collection platform that can put different sensors into the air in previously hard or impossible places to reach, said head of hardware and mechanical engineering at SenseFly, Adam Klapax. Mapping drones, together with photogrammetric software, can create high-resolution 2D and 3D models. One example of the use of such models is to analyze the hydrology of an area that's prone to flooding. Understanding the land in detail and predicting where it will flood can enable the construction of flood barriers in the current places. Drone Adventures conducted one such mission in Haiti. Terrain models can also be used to predict and analyze other disasters such as landslides or avalanches, said Klapax. Drones with meteorological sensors could probably be used to measure storms as well. What skills do we need? The basis of it is photography, and there is a basic rule that all good photographic principles apply. So, it's really important to be able to understand what the camera is doing, and how you can make the best of some of the more challenging situations. Remote sensing and drones are relatively new to the field, but aerial photogrammetry is not new. In fact, aerial photography and photogrammetry are closely tied together as early as the 1850s, and made great progress in the First and Second World Wars. Photogrammetrist is a professional who uses photogrammetric technology to extract measurements and make maps and interpret data from images. The photogrammetrist is responsible for all phases of mapping and other mensuration requirements, which include planning and supervising survey activities for control, specifying photography or other imagery requirements, managing projects for mapping or other mensuration requirements, and interpretation. How will we know where we are heading if we don't know where we are coming from? It's easy to forget that many of the techniques we use today are based on early works from hundreds of years ago. It began with Leonardo da Vinci, who worked on projective geometry, and continued on with artists like Albrecht Dürer, who used the laws of perspective to create an instrument that could be used to create a true perspective drawing. Did you know? The distance between two points that lie on a plane parallel to the photographic image plane can be determined by measuring their distance on the image, if the scale, S, of the image is known. This is done by multiplying the measured distance by 1/S.